Hello everyone, I'm Andrew Benjamin, the Love Doctor, and I specialize in catching people creeping, lying, and cheating in relationships. Today's video, I'm going to show you how to get even with a narcissist. Violation is a New York term for taking things too far that causes a beatdown. A vigilante is a person who takes the law into his own hands. Retribution is the dispensing of punishment for a violation. The purpose of retribution is to bring closure. It releases the hard, hateful feelings and emotions to move on with your life. When you haven't achieved closure, trauma is formed by repeatedly reliving the abuse, thinking how you should have responded. Operative word here, responded. Be honest. You're upset because you didn't do anything, and your narc just walked away unpunished. In case you didn't know, humans are the deadliest animals on Earth. Researchers have found that humans murder about 437,000 people each year. The deadliest species of humans are narcissists. Their venom destroys the soul.
It was just a fucking car, just a fucking dog.
Just a dog. Vigo.
Yeah.
When Ellen died, I lost everything. Until that dog arrived on my doorstep. A final gift for my wife. In that moment, I received some semblance of hope. An opportunity to grieve unalone. And your son took that from me. Stole that from me. Killed that from me! People keep asking if I'm back, and I haven't really had an answer. But now, yeah, I'm thinking I'm back. So you can either hand over your son, or you can die screaming alongside him!
Assassination is a business, and it's nothing personal. This movie, John Wick, is about assassins. John Wick, the best of the best, explains why the violation of his dog took him out of his character and made it personal. His objective became punishing those responsible and anyone that gets in his way. Isn't this your story? Someone stolen, taking your happiness, killed your good nature, for no reason other than they can. And now you want justice, which is nothing more than the politically correct word for revenge. This is what you have to do to get better. Punish your narcissist. Narcissists are assassins that carry out emotional murder. You have to become a punisher to exact retribution. Go to boot camp on red flag number 371. To punish a monster, you have to be focused with a purpose, allowing nothing and no one to get in your way. Rage empowers you for this mission. If you are not enraged, you are with a narcissist. And this video is not for you. Speaking from experience, when you leave the narcissist, it would seem so important for people to see the truth. Since killing them is not an option, exposure is the best way to punish monsters. You have to become creative to make the monster's life a living hell. Narcs leave a lasting effect on you, thus you have to do the same to them. Pics like this will have the narc worrying about their grandchildren seeing them and saying, "Oh wow, grandma was a hoe." It's one thing narcs can't do. They can't hide their indiscretions. View red flag number 47, narcissistic lies that backfire. Narcs go to social media to tell lies, therefore you go to social media to tell the truth. comments from those listening to you will make you feel better. Like, I don't see how anyone can believe her version of anything she says. From his side of the story, she did him grimy as fuck. You will get to see the monster complain. They say when you avoid the Narc, it gets easier. But on social media, it's so much harder since they follow me every place I go. I had to change my gamer tag at least 7 times and forum names at least that many times. It's so bad I can't remember the last time I didn't filter my thoughts in self-help chats. See? No one's believing the Narc anymore. And now they're careful of what they say. Because my Narc's favorite lie on social media topics was, only men cheat. My monster's family knew something was wrong with her. They just didn't know what it was. You have to get creative. My YouTube channel revealed the problem with narcissism. The family contacted me to give me their condolences. I wanted the family to know the truth, and they believed me. With them saying, Mother, we tried to warn you because we were fond of you. The sister was like, she was caught in so many colossal lies, she can't weasel her way out of this one. Also saying, when my family has done wrong, blood is not thicker than water. Did this make me feel better? Hell yeah! I had an orgasm better than my right hand. That last statement implies their family are distancing themselves from the monster. People who are not of a nature, evil, remove themselves from the nature. I assure you, whenever the family sees my monster, they're thinking, how could you be capable of doing such a thing? And the man the monster left me for speaks volumes of her dysfunction. Don't feel bad for causing a rift between the monster and his family. Quote him a woman from my first book. I'm a firm believer in payback. Trust and believe. If I'm hurting, everyone involved is going to get hurt. Retribution is a dish best served cold. And you have to put your empathy in check. Therefore, you have to look at the Narc's family as collateral damage. You know what's funny? I miss the Narc's family more than the monster. They had more respect for me. And they were fun to be with. I hope they read my book so I know how I felt about them. Now the Narc is going to recruit idiots for damage control. That so-called life coach, spiritual whistleblower, tried to make me look like the Narc and make my monster look like the victim. However, her projection made a laughing stock out of herself. Witness for yourself. Telling people making acceptable videos about a person shows they have a problem. When she makes excessive videos attacking people. Listen to Jezebel contradict herself while viewing the 27 videos she made about me. Some 3 in one day.
I mean, all it takes is 1-2 videos tops to expose the person. But when you keep putting one video out after the next, after the next, after the next, it really puts a spotlight on your obsessive behavior. Put, you know, you're going to expose somebody, expose them, and then let people decide for themselves. But, you know, if it gets to the point where you're posting 10 or more videos, dude, look in that mirror because y'all, you got a problem.
Also, everyone knows my story. A trifling bitch that relocates me 1,500 miles away twice for marriage while seeing someone else. calls her fiance at 5 o'clock in the morning from another man's bed to tell him she's sleeping with someone else, and have the man text the fiance she's in good hands. Anyone that defends that shit is full of shit. Remember my saying comments will make you feel better? One of my subscribers talking about spiritual whistleblower. That woman is identical to Lilith and can relate. Therefore, condoning Lilith gives her a peace within herself to make herself feel better about being a downright trifling nasty whore. Another subscriber. That Jezebel is no fucking queen. She doesn't even realize how many people be clowning her. Come the fuck on. She has Jezebel in her name. That says a lot about her. Jezebel, you aren't a life coach. You're a fucking joke. My monster has no bound. Monsters have no boundaries. So expect an alliance with your ex. Everything loving they were saying about you will shockingly be the opposite. You start thinking to yourself, well, that's not what you were saying to me when you were with me. The alliance attempting to hurt me had me laughing so hard, I misspelled stakes when I created this meme. I anticipated this in my book on page 440. All they did was confirm I know what I'm talking about in psychology. That makes me feel great, knowing I have a future giving the right advice to people about their ratchet behavior. People's comments making you feel good. Coach Drew knows his stuff and can psychologically analyze the situation and predict the behavior of these fools. By the way, along with my diploma, I will be certified as a life coach in October. Monsters hate your accomplishments. So in conclusion, getting the best of your narcissist expedites your recovery. You will be sad. You will play sad music. You will miss the good times. But you won't have PTSD. Bad memories is what keeps you in depression. The best way to recover from depression is to make new memories. Your new memories will be visualizing the monster annoyed and pissed. I have to warn you. If you get payback, the maximum F you, and you're still angry, this is called suffering. You will need a professional to help you at this point. The truth hurts.